Thank you all for coming. I've never told this story before. This is the story of the best 24 hours of my life. The day I met Eleanor. Life's tapestry is rich and woven out of moments. Some are bright, candescent light. Others, born of depths, perpetually dark. Act One. Dreams of Creation.
Up the road, in his shack, the old man was sleeping again. He was still sleeping on his face, and the boy was sitting by him, watching him. The old man was dreaming about the lions.
Might not be as big a box office hit, but it's worth a read.
Please.
No, I love film. Peter O'Toole, greatest actor that ever lived. Seriously, this is a great book. You should read it. I've read it like 300 times. If you, do you want to swap? I tell you what. Why don't I write my number in the front, and then if you want to swap back. Give me a call. At this point, Eleanor's phone goes off. Now, if there's one thing we know about Eleanor, it's that she's obsessed with the ocean. Her ringtone is a sonar radar. She leaves. She makes the cutest facial expression, like, I have to take the call, so I'm off. I let her go. I think I'm in love with her. She's the most beautiful woman I've ever met. She looks like Audrey Hepburn, but more exotic, if you can believe that. Just as I'm scribbling my number in my book, she pops up behind me, as Eleanor inevitably does. She hands me her copy of Jaws. Her name and number written inside, and she drifts away, smooth as you like. She goes out the door, she looks over her shoulder, and says, that's one bad hat, Harry. And off she goes. I'm sat there, beautiful girl's number in my book. It's all I can do not to call her straight away. Her number into my contacts, and I customize her ringtone to a sonar radar so that I know when she calls me, it's her. I spend the next few hours thinking about Eleanor, and I should not be doing that. What I should be thinking about is the Lion in Winter. Today is the biggest audition of my life. 6 month run of the Lion in Winter in the West End. The Lion in Winter is a play written in 1966 by James Goldman. The film was made of it in 1968, the lead part played by Peter O'Toole. The story of Henry II and his wife Eleanor of Aquitaine, an imagined winter in a castle in 1183. Now, I don't know about you, but when I'm going on audition set in 1183, what the fuck do you wear? I mean, I'm going in a suit of armour. Walking away from the cafe, down Portobello Road, and something catches my eye. In a charity shop. A beautiful suit. I take a look at it, and it seems to speak to me. It says, buy me. I don't often get that, and many things, but I'm not shopping obsessed.
Approach it. I have a habit when I go to charity shops. Check the pockets. You never know what you're going to find. You never know what you'll find out about the history of the person that had it before. I check the left breast pocket. Nothing but lint. I check the right breast pocket. And I see something truly magnificent. The costume label. July 65. Peter O'Fucking-Two. I have Peter O'Toole's suit in my hands.
His fucking suit!
I play it cool. Go over to the cash register and I'm like, how much for the suit? £30.
£30?
I whack it down. I leave pronto. I get myself home as quick as I can. When I get home, I stand in my living room in front of my mirror. And I get into my suit of armor.
Audrey, obviously, I'm giving too quickly.
Seriously, your mother's supposed to have this.
I stand there in Peter O'Toole's suit. Peter fucking O'Toole's suit on me. I have my suit of armor. It's a little too big for me, but that's okay. I am resolved to do the My Life speech. I will go in there and I will be Peter O'Toole. Now, I don't know how well you know the line of legend.
I know it pretty fucking well.
My life, when it is written, will read better than it lived. Henry Fitzempress, first Plantagenet, prince at 21, the ablest soldier in an able time. He led men well. He cared for justice when he could, and ruled for 30 years a state as great as Charlemagne's. He married out of love, a woman out of legend. Not in Alexandria or Rome or Camelot has there been such a queen. She bore him many children, but no sons. King Henry had no sons. He had three whiskered things, but he disowned them.
You are not mine! We are not connected! I deny you! None of you within my kingdom! I wish you plague! May all your children breach and die!
My
boys have gone. I've lost my boys. I didn't get the part. Too young. Maybe I'll play Henry the Second one day, right? But I did get one more gift that day. Eleanor. Hello. It's funny how life imitates art. King Henry the Second married Eleanor of Aquitaine, and she bore him 3 sons. 9 months later, I married Eleanor of Brazil, and she's pregnant with fucking triplets. It's funny how life imitates art. Time's fabric, it unknits our happiness. Beloved artifacts are worn to threads that machinate and fall confusedly. Act 2. Dreams of Destruction.
Leave a message, I'll call you back. Hi, it's me. My water's broken. I'm at the hospital. I can't get a hold of you. Please don't miss this. I love you.
I am not an artist. I am not a success. I am not young. I was once. I am not talented. I was once. When I was younger, I wanted to be Peter O'Toole. You still do. Fair enough. I am a husband. Your wife is obsessed with sharks, with you. I am not an alcoholic. You're obsessed. I am a father. You just missed your children's birth. I'm a failure. Eleanor is not.
This area of the northeast coast of Brazil is a potentially unique breeding place for the Carcharodon carcharias and the great white shark. They are now endangered in most other places in the Atlantic.
You're going away.
Humans have perished, of course, as a result of their presence here, but on rare occasions.
I'm on 4.
And our objective is to determine how many of them are left to breed. We have tagged them all electronically, and we determine their location by radar and satellite.
3 months. Taking the kids?
Electronic tagging from last season has failed magnificently. We hope. Otherwise, we have lost in excess of 300 great whites this year. Which, of course, needless to say, is a tragedy beyond recognition.
Yes, yes, I know you have to go. No, I understand that, but I can't see them tonight. I'm working tonight. I've told you, will you listen to me? I'm not drinking again. No, I promise you on my life. Yeah, fine, don't fucking,
No, don't. Do you know what? Fuck you. Go swim with your fucking sharks and fuck them too! Fuck! Eleanor.
When I said fuck them too, I didn't mean the kids. Not even a little, no. I meant the sharks. I meant the sharks, the kids a little, no. No. I just wish I could speak to her again. You missed your chance. You know what comes next. Yes, I know what comes next. Wait. You've made a mistake. You've missed something. Chronologically, I mean, yeah, you can't have a breakup before the wedding. We had the wedding, we had the speech. No, no, fuck the speech. What about the song? The song was the most beautiful thing you ever did. The song was good. Yeah. The wedding. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so fucking much for coming. I know it's not tradition for the groom to make a speech, but I am not one to stick to tradition, as you know. Eleonora, my wife, I love you. Thank you for giving me everything you have, more than I deserve. I promise I will always be there for you. You are my star, my incandescent light in the darkness. Right, enough of the serious stuff. Let's get silly. I've never told anyone this story before. This is the story of the best 24 hours of my life. The day I met Eleanor. It's funny the way life imitates art. Henry II married Eleanor of Aquitaine, and she bore him 3 sons. 9 months later, I married Eleanor of Brazil, and she's pregnant with fucking triplets. It's funny how life imitates art. Eleanor, that day, I got me 3 gifts. I got a copy of Jaws. Signed. I got myself a new suit. Signed. And I got you. In recompense, I offer you Jaws as you have never seen it. I offer you a song for love, something to wear for you, and I offer you myself. And it's too late to say no, you've already said yes. I fucking love you, Eleanor.
Let's start again. Please give me second grace. Please give me second face. I've fallen far down. First time around. Now I sit on the ground in your way.
Now, if it's time to recompense for what's done, come, come sit down on the fence in the sun. And the clouds will roll by, we'll never deny that it's
it's really too hard for the fly. Please tell me your second name. Please play me your second game. I've fallen so far for the people you are. I just need your star for a day. So come, come rowing in my rowing boat by the bay. For now, I must know. See, she'll sigh, but she's no cause to cry, for it's really too high for the fly. I asked him to play that song at the funeral.
Did they?
I don't know. I never went.
What comes of human suffering and pain, but life and wounds that weep and weep and weep? Redemption or damnation from the deep? Act 3. Dreams of Redemption.
Chief. Don't you worry about it, Chief. It won't be permanent. You want to see something permanent? Boom, boom, boom. There you go. You want to feel something permanent? Just put your hand underneath my cap. Just feel that little lump. Knockanolum. St. Paddy's Day, Boston. I got that beat. I got that beat. Some more heel. Bit right through my wetsuit. Now listen, not about that, but I entered an arm wrestling contest at Oakley, San Francisco. I can't extend that. You know why? In the semifinal, celebrating my third wife's demise, big Chinese fella pulled me right over. Look at that. That's a bull shark. Scraping when I was taking samples. I got something for you. That's a thresher. See that, Chief? Thresher's tail. Thresher? It's a shark. Want a drink? Drink to your leg? I'll drink to your leg. So we drink to our legs. I got the creme de la creme. Right here. Now, you see that?
Mary Ellen Moffat. She broke my heart.
Chief, come on up! Yes!
Oh! Unlucky, Chief. What are we doing here, Chief? Yeah, what are we doing here?
Waiting?
What for, Chief? Something. Hope deferred maketh the something sick. You really think you've got a chance?
I don't think so, Chief. Three strikes and you're out.
Why are you talking about baseball when you should be thinking about sharks?
Check the radar, Chief.
Back, Chief. I'm back. Suppose talking about baseball is better than dreaming about lions.
Up the road in his shack, the old man was sleeping again. He was still sleeping on his face, and the boy was sitting by him watching him. The old man was dreaming about the lions.
But then everything is a sin. Do not think about sin. It's much too late for that, and there are people who are paid to do it. Let them think about it. You were born to be a fisherman, as a fish was born to be a fish. St. Peter was a fisherman, as was the father of the great DiMaggio. He was an old man who fished alone in a skiff in the Gulf Stream, and he had gone 84 days now without taking a fish. In the first 40 days, a boy had been with him. The road in his shack, the old man was sleeping again. He was still sleeping on his face, and the boy was sitting by him, watching him. The old man was dreaming about the lions. You dare to damn me, do you? Yeah, I'll damn you back.
God damn you!
My boys. Lost my boys. Jesus Christ, all my boys.
You read the Bible, Chief?
You should maybe think about that, Chief. Yeah, I've read it. But I don't believe it. Chief.
Go on, Chief. Oh!
Why are there so many of you? Why are you so quiet? Say something. Say something to me. Fucking hell, there's so many of you. We're gonna need a bigger boat. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing at me? It's come to my attention that some of you do not believe I am who I am. I would that I could not believe in you.
but I've based my entire life on belief. And now I don't believe that belief is worth believing. What's it worth believing when you have no one to believe in? When you have nothing. I do not believe because this lies. And this lies, and my eyes. My eyes lie.
To you.
Did you want to do a speech, or did you want to?
We wanted to dedicate tonight's performance to an actor called Alex Giannini, who very sadly passed away 2 weeks ago. He was only 52, and I had the pleasure and privilege of working with him, directing him in a short film about 11 years ago, a short black and white film. And this is for Alex Giannini, and for all you lovely people, and for this wonderful man who made basically.
Thank you.